Now it's time to share about the man behind our success. I take this opportunity to introduce the patron and our beloved principal, sir, Dr. P. Santosh Kumar Patra, sir. Dr. P. Santosh Kumar Patra, sir, holds BE, M.Tech and PhD degree in computer science and engineering. And for more than 18 years, sir has been an active academician and educational administrator. Sir's area of interest includes artificial intelligence, software engineering, data mining and warehousing, and wireless network. Sir has been honored with Governor Award thrice, Rashtriya Gaurav Award, Rashtriya Vikas Ratan Award, Dronacharya Award, and Young Leader by IBAE Dubai. Adding features to the cap, Sir has been glory achievements under his name. Sir has published 24 patents and has written 12 books and more than 88 international papers, including Scopus and SCI, 16 magazine articles and 138 newspaper coverage. Recently, Sir has been honored as an advisor to NAC, Bengaluru, UGC, Paramarsh, National Cyber Safety and Security Standard Government of India. Sir has been in editorial board of many publications like Tata Magro Hills, High Tech Publications, Charulata Publications, etc. Under Sir's leadership, college has received many heights like NAC A+, UGC Autonomous, NIRF ranking. Sir has received 86 lakhs from DST IIT Bombay and from AICT. Also received consultancy project worth of rupees 444 crores rupees from GHMC Hyderabad. Also received an amount of 31 lakhs for UGC Paramarsh. Sir is one of the great missionary leader, inspiration to all of us. Now, I take this opportunity to invite our principal, sir, to give his inaugural address. Over to you, sir.
So, thank you, Shweta Madam, for a brief introduction. So, is it audible? Voice is clear? So, respected Chairman, Sri M. Lakshman Reddy, sir, respected Executive Director, Sri G. Chandrasekhar Yadav, sir, and Chief Guest of today's program, Dr. T. Russo, Associate Consultant, Wipro Technology from Solinganallur, Chennai. All the resource person, invited guest, dean, all the HODs, and convener of this today's program, Dr. M. Narayanan, who is the professor and HOD of Computer Science and Engineering, and co-convener of today's program, Dr. T. Pungadai, who is professor and HOD of CSE with a specialization Artificial Intelligence and Machine Learning. Program coordinator Dr. Satish and Dr. Rajalingam, all the advisory committee member, organizing committee secretaries and faculty member of this great department of computer science and engineering, and last but not the least, participant across the country. A very good morning to all of you. I am Dr. Santosh Kumar Patro, principal of St. Martin Engineering College. Wholeheartedly, I would like to welcome you all to this phase two titled as Sensor Network, Internet of Things and Internet of Everything, AICT sponsored 1 week online short term training program, which is scheduled from today and it will go up to 22nd of May. First of all, at the outset, I would like to thank AICT for approving our proposal and showing interest on us so that we can disseminate the knowledge by pulling all the best resources across the country and disseminate the knowledge for all the faculty community, so that the objective of AICT is through faculty, the knowledge should be shared with the students. So everybody has to be enlightened and ignited with the power of knowledge. So first, at the outset, I would like to thank AICT for showing interest and believing us. And this is our second FDP, AICT sponsored FDP program, as it is already mentioned by Dr. Narayanan. And I would like to thank and appreciate Dr. Narayanan and his team and Dr. Pongadai for taking so much of keen interest and very tactfully and very systematically for organizing this STTP for the benefit of the society. And as already it has been informed by Dr. Shweta that how many number of events have been organized by the department for past 1 year as well as past 2 years. And I must appreciate the department and the HOD that past all the events are mega success, and undoubtedly with your hard work and dedication, this program is going to be a big success. So I would like to really appreciate and I would like to thank our chief guest of today's program, Dr. T. Russo, with a very small short notice, sir has agreed. And today, sir is with us to enlighten us the industry practices, sensor network and IoTs, and also to give us the path how the industries nowadays, it is all working in the pandemic too. So thank you very much, sir. Wholeheartedly, we'd like to thank you for your kind acceptance and given your consent to be with us today. Wholeheartedly, I would like to welcome you to this program. And coming to the title, as you know that the title is quite interesting, where it is a blended approach of sensor network, Internet of Things, and Internet of Everything. See, this Internet of Things, it is not a new concept to us. And when we were small children also, that time we had a practice of using the internet and as well as IoT objects. Still, I could able to recall when I was a 7th or 8th standard boy, so my father had bought one small device which I need to connect it to our pedestrian fan, and if I will give one clap, the fan used to rotate, and if I will give two claps, the fan used to stop. So I was so fascinated and excited by seeing that device. So whatever my father used to give some instruction or work to me, I was very much obliged by hoping that I will get a similar kind of item as a next gift for me. And I have gone one step ahead. I have invited all of my classmates to the home and I had shown that device. So that was the era. And this IoT has gone with multi-folded, and now everywhere, you take the example of house, you take the example of offices, you take the example of working atmosphere, travel, transport, logistic arrangement, you just name it out, okay, everywhere the presence and existence of IoT is available. And looking into the present scenario of the pandemic, so nobody had predicted that IoT will make a big difference in every individual's life. Recently, I was reading one magazine article which was released by the Empirical College of London. And they had estimated, as you know, that when the first wave of COVID-19 pandemic came, so only there are two treatments. One is what? We have to have mask, and second one is social distancing. And it is estimated, and the research says, because of these two situations, we were able to save 3 million lives in the Europe alone. And how this social distancing and monitoring people are whether really wearing the mask or not, how it is all monitored? It is all monitored by using the IoT technology. And recently, I was reading one more article where I came to know that the vaccine companies, there are different vaccine companies are there for the COVID-19, and there are two companies which are very popular. One is Pfizer and another one is BioNTech. So now these two companies, they have adopted a technology that is named as Controlant, and by using this IoT technology, they are monitoring the vaccine distribution, and also there should not be any product loss, there should not be any tampering in the product, and there should not be any spoilage. So these are all possible by using the IoT technology. And in addition to that, I am very excited to share with you all, and you are already familiar with this. First time in this world, so Germany, normally they are very strict on rules and guidelines, and wherever there is a application or there is a product which has to be used in the area of healthcare domain. So in October 2020, just, you know, 6-7 months before, Germany first time they allowed the doctors to prescribe access to the digital health applications for specific diseases. And in India already, you know that in the TV also, a lot of times the advertisements are coming. The Practo is the new doctor's app where we can fix an appointment and interact with the doctors and have a consultation with all these things. Then these are all about the IoTs and these are all about the applications and usage of IoTs. Then what is new in it? So very interestingly, there is a buzzword nowadays across the globe that is named as AIoT. And this A stands for artificial IoT. What is artificial IoT? It is just a combination of artificial intelligence plus Internet of Things. And in December 2020, just again 6-7 months before, there was a report and which shows that, see, normally any activity will be done and any recent topic comes, there are a lot of researchers who are all showing keen interest and they go for Google search. Anything you wanted to know in detail, what do? You go for a Google search, right? Okay, so in December 20, so the Google has given a report that 70% of the Google search had happened on the recent developments on IoT. So this shows people are very much aware and it has got the huge potentiality for the research and as well as for the development. And looking into the business point of view, I was reading one Economics Time, one magazine, and there I came to know that there is a company called C3AI, C3.AI. You can Google it and find out. It is the company who deals with IoT related products and all. So this company decided to release its IPO, initial public offer, where the public is allowed to be a part of the company in the form of purchasing the shares. And very surprisingly, people were debating on it, whether it is only it deals with the IoT products and all, what will be the growth phenomenon and what will be the business potentiality and future of the company. And last year, the IPO was released, almost 40 times it is oversubscribed. Means people have believed, people have convinced, and people are ready to accept the change in the field of IoT. So why I am telling to you all this means this field has got a phenomenal growth in the sector of development, in the sector of product development, in the sector of service providing, and in the sector of research. So I really appreciate the HOD and all the coordinators and staff members, those who have decided to coin this as a title for the benefit of all the participants. And also I congratulate all the participants, because if you look into the resource person who are all available for continuously 6 days, they are all the best in industry and they are good and having very good knowledge on all these areas. So hope by using and attending all these sessions, your knowledge matrix will improve. So it will be useful for your research and further it will be useful to disseminate the knowledge for the student community. And finally, I would like to pass this message to all the participants that Department of CSE is doing a phenomenal work. I think this is their 23rd or 24th online event, which are all a mega success. And by June and July, they are already embedded with a lot of activities. And the iconic event, what I felt, is the international conference, what they have planned. And already department has signed an MOU with many national and international level of UGC CARE and Scopus indexed journal. And they are going to give the benefit who are all submitting the paper to give a free publication to just to support the faculty and student community. So I appreciate the entire department, including Dr. Narayanan and Dr. Pungadai, for your Nobel initiative. And finally, all the very best. And thank you for giving me the opportunity and listening to me. And please do take care of yourself. Have a great day ahead. Thank you for the opportunity.